Hey, what's up guys? So in this video I'm going to show you how you can create this beautiful typography text-based t-shirt design. Now the idea here is to get an edge over the simple text-based design, you know, just the simple plain text, nothing decorative in it, so that you can get more sales as compared to those designs. Now if you are interested in that, let's get started. So here I have created a new document inside Affinity Designer, and the size is according to the size of merch by Amazon. So I'm just going to create a black background by creating a rectangle the size of the document and then filling it with simple black background. But now let's just lock it and let's just put some words here using the artistic text type tool, and I'm just going to type some words here and let's just make it bigger. And now I'm going to align it at the center so that even if I need to change the words, all of our text is actually aligned at the center. We do not have to readjust it. Next, I'm going to change the font to be slightly thinner but taller. Let's just scale it up even further. I think that looks fine. And now you can see there is a lot of space between the lines of the text, and I'm not liking that. So I'll just decrease this spacing between the text, between the lines, and using this character tool, actually character panel. I think that looks fine, and just readjust it, and I think that looks fine. Okay, now we want to start creating the design. So there are two designs that I would like to show you here. The first one is, let's just remove any kind of fill color, and instead we need some kind of stroke color. So I'll just use this simple white color as a stroke color and increase the stroke width. I think that looks fine. But now I want to have some kind of slanted lines, diagonal style lines in it, and some of the text to be filled and some of the text should be just empty with just outlines of the text. So in order to do that, first I'm going to just, you know, use this pen tool and then create a, you know, kind of like an area with a slanted lower edge. So just like that one, and I'm going to fill it with, let's say, just fill it white color, and then I'm going to create a copy of this one by pressing Ctrl J, and then I'm going to flip it vertically and then again flip it horizontally and then move it down. You know, now you can see that both of these edges, these line endings, are actually in parallel, and that's what I wanted. Now I'm going to make both of these a child of our text. So I'll just select both of these and make it a child of our text. As you can see, our design is already looking pretty interesting, but even to make it even further interesting, let's just bring it down and maybe bring this one down a little bit, something like that, so that our, you know, top word is covered by that. You can adjust it later on as you would like. It doesn't really matter. Okay, now that our text is looking beautiful, one thing we can do to make it even further interesting, to have some kind of, you know, line coming out of these edges. So in order to do that, what I'm going to do is this. I use this pen tool, and as soon as I, you know, bring it near the edges of the shapes that I have already created, you can see a yellow highlight. That means it's showing you that it is at the border of this shape. So I'll just press once here and another time just like that here, and for this I'm just going to create a stroke here and maybe increase the stroke width, something like that. This is looking beautiful. And another thing that I would like to do is to create a copy of this one by pressing Ctrl J and then move it down a bit like that. As you can see, our design is already looking beautiful, and you can, you know, be satisfied with it and then upload it on the, you know, platform where you sell the t-shirts. The another thing that you can do here is to change the colors of this text at the top and at the bottom. But the problem here occurs is that now that we have a stroke on our, you know, text actually. So if I change the color here, let's say for this shape, you can see that the stroke is already there. Now if you want to keep that stroke and design it like that, that totally depends upon you. But let me show you another way to an interesting design that you can create with this one. So I'll just make it white. So you see that I have created these horizontal lines that I here and at the top and at the bottom of the edges. Let's just decrease its our stroke width maybe to 8, something like that. That looks fine. So I'm going to select this top horizontal actually diagonal line, and then I'm pressing Ctrl J, create a copy of it and move it slightly downward like that. Then I'm going to press Ctrl J a couple of times to create multiple copies of the at the same distance. So something like that would be great. So I'm going to select this one and then the second last of these lines, press Ctrl G to group them together and then make it a child of our text. And now you can be satisfied with like that, or you can color these top lines that you have created and maybe make it something different, something like that maybe. Now it totally depends upon you how would you like to see your design. And this is another interesting design, two color design, but a beautiful type of style design. Or you can just simply remove it and sell it like that, or you can type select the text tool, cancel or remove any kind of the stroke and sell it like that. Or even further, if you want to make it multicolor design, you can select these colors, shapes, and color them differently. Maybe something like that would be fine. And maybe let's just select this one and change it to, let's say, yellow or maybe red, whatever looks fine. I think that is looking much better in my opinion. So yeah, this is how you can create interesting t-shirt design. And a simple text-based design, it doesn't take much time, but it gives you an edge over just the plain text t-shirt design. Now if you want to change it for some other type of text, you can simply edit the text and the rest of the design will be the same. So you can create multiple versions of the codes, multiple t-shirt design in just a few seconds. Let me just show you how you can easily change it. So I can change it to be a nice human. So you can see that in just by changing the text, I can change the design and create a different t-shirt version. And if you want, you can change the colors as well. So sometimes you might not have these four lines of the text. So for example, something like that, like never stop trying. So in this case, for example, you have only this thing, and you can adjust it, but you can see that our text actually the design that is below it actually moves with it, so which we do not want it. Let me show you what you can do in that case. So in that case, you can just select all of the childs of that text and then move them up or down according to your likeness and according to whatever you see fit for your design. Let me just scale it up a bit. So as you can see, once I scale it up, all of our designs that are the child of this text are also scaling up, and that gives us an interesting, you can say, t-shirt design. Again, if you want to put the lines up there, you can simply put it, and you can also add more design elements as you would like. You're not limited to these simple lines. You can make some kind of maybe like a zigzag type of lines, or maybe kind of like a wave style lines. So that totally depends upon you. And that's how you can make your simple t-shirt designs, simple text-based designs interesting, and make it look unique from the rest of the design that are just plain text t-shirt designs. So guys, hopefully you have found this video and these tips to be useful for your t-shirt design business. If so, make sure that you like the video. It will help me with the YouTube algorithm, and hopefully I'll see you in the next video, and thank you for watching.